Oh, is that?
Thank you. Evening, everyone. Why do we start off with some soft music and sit there and listen to prepare our minds for the things that we're going to hear today? The things that we're going to talk about, the words you're going to hear, that how we share in our grief and our sorrows and that time of disappointment and darkness in our life. So we prepare for this and knowing, and we've kind of been talking all along, that we are all in this together, that we are family, and there is nothing that you do alone. That God, not only is God there with you, but we are there as well. There's going to be a series of things that we're going to do this evening, and we'll kind of talk you through all of these different things. We have here in the front of the church, that tree has been here with the bulbs all for all of Advent, and not everybody has known why. We're going to find out why tonight, you know, what its purpose is. We're going to light candles in memory of people. We're going to, you know, light candles for a struggle or a sorrow or something that we're going through, but we're also going to sit in darkness and grieve together. But we're also going to come out of that, and we're going to fellowship together after the service is over. So just try and listen to everything that's going to go on and be a part of all of this. Today was the shortest day, and tonight the longest night of the year. At noon, if you had have glimpsed your shadow, it too would have been the longest one of all the year. While we're in the midst of the season of great joy and light, for many of us in this room and in this world, it feels more like a season of great darkness and shadows. While others are experiencing the light of hope, peace, joy, and love, we may feel as though our hope is gone. Our peace has been extinguished. Our joy snuffed out. And love vanished. That we don't have to be alone in our darkness tonight. We're here together. And we can honestly be here, for God has promised to meet us and welcomes us just as we are. Let us read aloud the prayer that is in your program. Let us read this together. God, we bring you to our grief, our sorrows, although we may not know you are with us as much as in the dark as in the light, we admit we are.
Remind us tonight, as you have reminded all people through all ages, that you are Emmanuel, God with us. You join us and continue loving us in our loneliness, anger, and fear. May we allow you to be with us, to be our guide, healer, comforter, and friend in the darkest of times. Amen.
Tonight we're going to listen to some scriptural laments. What is a lament? A lament is a passionate expression of grief or sorrow. Not any different than any of us may be sitting here this evening. Now hear these voices from the scriptures.
Cried the psalmist, "My tears have been my food day and night, while people say to me all day long, 'Where is your God?'"
Through his tears he said, "Why am I discouraged? Why is my heart so sad? I will put my hope in God. I will praise him again, my Savior and my God. Now I am deeply discouraged, but I will remember you."
Cried Jeremiah, "Peace has been stripped away, and I have forgotten what prosperity is. I cry out, 'My splendor is gone. Everything I hope for from the Lord is lost.'"
Peace of mind and heart. And in the end, says the book of Revelation, he will wipe away every tear from their eyes.
We're going to play a song, and it's supposed to be a time of reflection on the scriptural verses, so the words will be up on the screen from the scripture readings, and then just some music in the background for contemplation.
Thank you.
see yourself in the scriptures that we read today, this evening? Did you see yourself in your grieving, in your sorrow, in your time of darkness? Did you see yourself when the psalmist said, "My tears have been my food both day and night"? The struggles are deep and the struggles are real. Did you see yourself in the psalm when it said, through his tears he said, "Why am I discouraged? Why is my heart so sad? I will put my hope in God." Trying to come out of the darkness and says, "Why am I so sad? I will put my hope in God." Trying to lift himself from the darkness alone and by himself. Do you see yourself as Jeremiah, where Jeremiah says, "Peace has been stripped from me. Prosperity no longer exists. My splendor is gone. I have nothing. Everything I hoped for from the Lord is lost"? Do you see yourself in the words of Jeremiah? Do you see yourself as one who has the tears and still dares to hope, to try and make the best of what you have? And you try and remember all that you had, and you do your best to have the faith of and the love that God has given you that never ends. His mercies never cease. Great is his faithfulness. But still, the darkness just casts across you and doesn't want to leave. Did you see yourself when Jesus from the cross, in the midst of the darkness, says, my God, why have you forsaken me?" How many times have we had this thought run across our minds? And to his friends, the apostles, Jesus says, "I will leave you a gift, peace of mind and heart. And the peace I give, the world can no longer give. The world doesn't have the ability to give you what I am going to give you. Look beyond the darkness and into the light and see the gift as something God has given you." Do you find yourself in this place, waiting again how God says, "I will come again to be with you"? In his reassuring words, "I have told you these things while I am with you. My peace I give to you." This world will only have trouble. But take heart. I have overcome the world. And then the reassuring words, can you see that what Revelation tells us? Tells us that he will wipe every tear from your eyes, and there will be no more dark, no more death, no more sorrow, no more pain. All these things are gone forever. Do you see these things? Where do you find yourself in these words that the scriptures give us this evening? We're going to take a moment and I'm going to engage your imagination. We're going to go through a prayer imagining that Jesus actually being Emmanuel. Emmanuel is God with us, is what Emmanuel means. So we're going to imagine that Emmanuel, God, is with us this evening. So carefully listen to the words I say to you. And just have this vision within your mind that Emmanuel is right here, right now, with us. Closing your eyes, imagine Jesus coming into this room. He sees you. And he makes his way over to you. Notice how Jesus chooses to sit, stand, or kneel right there beside you. What is it that he wants? What is it that he wants to offer you right now? All you have to do is simply allow him to be with you however he chooses. Maybe he shares a few words with you. Maybe the facial expression of Jesus in your mind right now is all you need. Maybe a gesture or simply his presence can bring hope for you. Allow yourself to be with Jesus in the silence just for a moment. He's here. He's with you. Emmanuel. God is with us. Amen. And now I'm going to hear a song. It's called Some of Us. And the words are on the back of your hymnal if you want to follow along or, you know, to listen to the words. But listen to the song and reflect on that moment that you just had.
Some of us have
rest of the... For the rest of the service, it's, there is no ending, scripted ending for this service. We're going to take some time and we'll sit in darkness. We're going to sit and reflect on the things that we've heard. And you will be invited to sit for as long as you want in the darkness and silence. And some of you may think, I'm tired of sitting in darkness and silence, acknowledging loss, maybe separation, maybe confusion over something that you have experienced through others. The darkness and silence may feel a little uncomfortable at first. Darkness and silence can be scary no matter what age you are, yet it is our prayer tonight that you begin to feel comfortable. That you begin to feel God's presence, God's invitation to rest and to be still. And we can begin to experience the darkness around us as a way of embracing God. A God who is present with us always, maybe even more powerfully in our pain. And a God who promises that it will not be dark forever. Tomorrow there will be just a little bit more light than there was today. You may not have noticed, but slowly spring will be coming again. A little hope for you there. Maybe it is in the same way as God brings a little light into your life, into the world. After a time of silence and darkness, we will light a candle, which represents the presence of Christ. And whenever you want to come up, you will be invited, meaning on your own, whenever you're ready, to come forward and to light a candle of your own. That's what the candle's in the front. It can represent some struggle that you have, a loss. It can be a struggle with someone. It can be many things that we light a candle for. You're welcome to pray here at the up front. I would be glad to pray with you if you would like. There is no formal ending to this evening. Just take time and space that you need to reflect and to be in the presence of God. Afterwards, we will leave here and go into the fellowship hall and we will have refreshments together. Because part of what this evening is about is that we are all in this together. We are all family and we all have struggles and we all have difficulty. And so we'll sit in the darkness together, but in the presence of God. So as we enter into the darkness, the lights will be turned on. We'll hand you the lighter whenever you want to come up to light a candle. There are crosses on the table. If you did not get, we had them out last year. If you did not get one and you would like one, you can grab one of those. There's a little prayer card and there's the lights there. And grab a bulb off of the tree to represent that person, that someone you lost, that struggle that you're truly holding on to. It's a clear bulb. Take it home, hang it up, remember it, keep it as a memory. But as I said, whenever you want to come up, come and do that. And after you're done, if someone would like to be prayed for, I'll be up here to pray with you. And then we'll all meet back in the fellowship hall.